Hey guys, welcome back. So, what are we going to talk about today? Not really sure. I wanted to update you on things that the bags that I've decided are going to go on the chopping block. So as you know, there's a YSL camera bag that I've put up on eBay. My Christian Dior, what do you call this? Christian Dior oblique patent mini Boston bag is also up for sale on eBay. The reason why the camera bag is for sale is because I think I have other bags that serve the same purpose. And when I bought that, I was like, yeah, I like how understated it is, because it's like, it's just got an embossed YSL on it and not the actual emblem of YSL. But right now I actually feel like I want something that's got the emblem of YSL, because I feel like it makes it so classy, and also it's just pretty. And the other one, the reason why I wanted to sell the Christian Dior patent bag is because it's patent. Now, I don't really have a problem with it because it's black, so it won't show like if there's any yellowing that's happening. But I do know that patent leather tend to get sticky over time, especially if they're left out in the sun or whatever. And I just don't want to deal with that kind of fussiness to take care of the bag. Like, even now when I store it, I put paper between the bag and the handles, just in case, you know. And it's stored in a sort of like dark area so that there's no sunlight that hits it. But when summer comes, and how hot it gets here in Australia, I'm gonna let go of that. Even though I really love the look of it, I'll probably try and find one that is not as fuzzy, or in a different material. I'm not sure yet. I do like the oblique print of Christian Dior, but I haven't found a mini Boston bag that I like from them that is within the price range that I'm willing to pay. Let me clarify that. There's a lot of good stuff in Christian Dior, but I just don't want to pay the price for a secondhand vintage kind of bag that's more than $1,000 or $1,200. That's not just gonna happen. Right. So those things are already in the chopping block, but I've also, I don't know if you can see it, but there used to be the Coach Field Tote 30 and the horse and carriage print. So that's up on Facebook Marketplace now, and a few other groups on Facebook. I'm gonna try to sell it there first before I put it up on eBay. However, I am selling it without the long strap, okay, because the long strap is staying. I mean, let me see. Because I'm using it currently now with my Balenciaga hip bag. Love the combination. So I'm definitely not letting go of the strap. Okay, that's staying with me. So the bag has not actually been, well, it's been used once, I think. And I'm selling it for $300 under retail. And it's current season. Right, it's still, I can still see it on display at the Coach Boutique here in Sydney at QVB. Anyways, go back there. Right, so those are on the chopping block. I am also considering selling this guy here. Now, the YSL camera bag is on the chopping block because this actually does what that bag does. Like, it serves the same purpose. But when I look at my bags, all of them actually serve the same purpose, which is to carry stuff, right? So I don't know. I am thinking about selling this. But I really like it. If I do end up selling this, I probably will get another one in a different color. I know I kind of talked crap about the tan one, but the tan one is just so pretty. So I don't know. I'm contemplating on selling this to get the tan one, because I'm not gonna keep two Loewe puzzle bags. Okay, no. But we'll see. We'll see. I haven't decided yet. It's still on display, so therefore it's still staying. There is one thing that I want to get, and I've been talking to Kenny about this. I'll show you guys. I'm gonna go ahead and do. Where is it? Here we go. Da 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 da. And I blame Mel in Melbourne for this. I stumbled upon her video talking about this clutch. And I only have one clutch, and it's this Alexander McQueen-esque $20 bag that I got from Salvos. However, as you can see, it's really tiny. And while it fits my phone, I would like one in a different color. As you can see, this one is black with sort of like, almost like ruthenium hardware. Almost like black on black, actually. But there is, one second. I'm doing a search on my phone for this. Monogram clutch. Okay, and you will see this pop somewhere here. There is one in particular that I want. Here we go. This one. I really am contemplating on getting this, because after I've watched Mel in Melbourne's video about how you can even turn it into a crossbody bag, and I do have a chain that would work for that purpose, I thought, actually, you know, it does fit quite a lot. I was toying with the idea, pun intended, with of getting the Toy Lulu, but that one is $1,990 currently, in the white with the gold hardware. This one I also want to get in the white, or they call it blank vintage, with a gold hardware. I really like the look of this. I like that you can fit quite a few things in it. I just don't know if my hand sanitizer will fit in there, because, you know, nowadays that's a consideration. But I know that both my card holder and my phone, and probably even my sunglasses, when it's in its soft case, will fit. So I am seriously thinking about this, and for 970 Australian dollars, that's not bad. Not bad at all for a leather YSL. It's got the wristlet attachment, which I probably will use. You could also remove that so that you can just hold it as a clutch. And then again, you can attach and there's various videos of this on YouTube, but I just haven't decided if I want to go for it. I am also very conscious that there might be a price increase. I don't know when. So if I do decide to get this, it definitely will be before any other price increases. But what I'd like to do is to sell the actual things that are on my chopping block before I buy anything new. And this YSL clutch would be replacing the Coach tote, because honestly, I only need one tote, and I'm definitely keeping my Chanel, so the Coach has got to go. Right. I think that's pretty much it. That was the purpose of this video, to tell you guys what I am planning on buying next and what I am planning, or I am currently selling. Okay, bye for now. Let me know, actually, let me know in the comment section down below. Are you currently minimizing your collection? Are you planning on replacing anything in your collection after you've sold them? What are you gonna get next? Okay.